Whether you have COVID symptoms or not, or whether you suspect you have COVID or not, it's still important to keep in mind the symptoms that are severe enough and concerning that should bring you to an emergency department or seek medical care. So whether you're experiencing severe symptoms related to COVID or not related to COVID, that include shortness of breath, severe chest tightness, confusion, passing out episodes, stroke-like symptoms like facial droop or weakness or numbness, you need to go to the closest emergency department or call 911 immediately. So if you do think that you're experiencing symptoms that are concerning for COVID, this may include fevers, body aches, joint aches, diarrhea, loss of the sense of taste or smell, but not so severe that you think it's an immediate threat and you need emergency care, I strongly encourage you to call your doctor's office or call your local health department to find out about mechanisms for testing locally for COVID. While vaccine is the first step in getting towards control of this pandemic, we still need to be extremely mindful and very careful of all the precautions we've been taking this past year. That means limiting in-person contact, social distancing, universal masking whenever possible, because it's going to take many, many months before we get a sufficient population vaccinated so that it'll really have the intended effect. If you suspect that you do have symptoms of COVID, I strongly encourage you to get tested at your local testing site or facility. And although it's really important to maintain the drive for vaccination of the majority of our population, again, it's going to be many months before we're seeing the desired outcome of that as it rolls out. I urge you and encourage you to be careful. Maintain all the precautions we have done. We've made it this far. We just need to make it a little further.